Hello guys, we are looking for the trailer 57488. We are here at the terminal in Hartland, New Brunswick. 57488. Here it is, on the left. Okay, let's go and hook up. It is a load for Pennsylvania, Allentown. Let's go to the inspection bay. After that we have to scale it. How much reefer we have? How much fuel? Half a tank. Delivery is on Wednesday, 10:30 in the morning in Allentown, Pennsylvania. I've been there last week. Same customer, AmeriCold. So there are two trucks ahead of us. The inspection bay is there on the left. There is one truck ahead of me. So see you later. Okay, let's go and scale the load. £11,000, we're okay. on our drives. 32,700, we're fine. $32,300. Great. So the final step before hitting the road is to go grab the paperwork, go to the office, grab the paperwork, and that's it. Wonderful day today. Temperature is 29 degrees, but it's no humid. The weather is, the atmosphere is dry. Okay, let's go and grab the paperwork. We are ready to roll. Tractor and trailer brakes released. So again, we have a load of French fries that needs to be delivered in Allentown, Pennsylvania. Our appointment is on Wednesday, 10:30 in the morning, and we are 1,100 kilometers to go. Local time is 5 o'clock here in New Brunswick, but when I cross the border, when I enter the state of Maine, the hour will go 1 hour behind, so 4 o'clock. I'm planning to drive for 5-6 hours. I'm gonna sleep probably in Kittery, Maine, just before New Hampshire, the border of, just right in the state line. There is a Irving truck stop. I'm gonna get fuel for my truck and for the reefer. I'm gonna sleep. Delivery. particular customer in Allentown. I have delivered the load at this customer, Americold, but not in Allentown. I was last week in Hartland, Pennsylvania, which is about less than an hour away from Allentown. Canada Highway. If you stay on this road, you will go all the way to Nova Scotia. Nova Scotia is the eastern part of Canada. You can't go more east, it's the ocean. And I'm not sure, but if you take the Trans-Canada way west, it goes all the way to British Columbia, to the west coast of Canada. I'm not 100% sure, but I know that this highway is very long. It's very, very long. But I don't know if it goes coast to coast. From where we are is 25 kilometers, and in order to cross it, at least for me, I'm not from Canada, I'm from Greece, I have to have with me my passport and another document that any tracker who wants to cross the border, you have to have the ACE. ACE. So pretty much my passport and the ACE. The ACE, this document has a barcode. The officer there at the border will scan it and it will show up all the information, where I'm going, what I hold, pretty much everything. All they need to know. Usually this border is not busy. Most of the time it takes 10-15 minutes maximum. But if you are coming back, if you want to go to come to Canada from the US, especially, I'm crossing most of the time from Buffalo to Fort Erie. There it's busier because most of the trucks going to Ontario. The most populated province of Canada. So most of the freight going there. Ontario and Quebec. Hello again, the state of Maine. I have been driving on Interstate 95 for the last 30 minutes. We are 50 kilometers past the border, 35 miles. And we're gonna stay on 95 for the most part of. I'm gonna take the exit 2, Kittery, Maine. It's about 4 hours from here, 4 hours drive. I'm gonna take the exit 2. I will sleep there at the Ivy truck stop. So the next 4 hours will be like that. Pretty much no traffic at all. Not a lot of people live in the northern Maine. It's exactly the same thing. Living in the biggest city of Greece, Athens, the capital. Around 5 million people living there. And when I first came in New Brunswick, it was a shock for me. The lifestyle is way different. Less people. Countryside, you need a car to go everywhere. But I don't know, so far I like it. Everything it has its pros and the cons, but it's so quiet. The place is lovely. You have, you know, rivers and mountains. No stress. Interstate 95 South, and we're coming up to 295. We are about an hour to Kittery, Maine, where we're gonna take our 10 hours off. We're about 65 miles. Where we're gonna fuel up and sleep. Tonight I'm gonna be having a nice sleep. Temperature is 20 degrees, 21 degrees right now. I'm not gonna need to idle the truck. I'm gonna crank the windows a little bit and I should be fine. So here I have the e-pass, so I don't have to stop and pay. That's it. No idea where I'm gonna be sleeping tomorrow. A friend of mine told me that there is a spot 3 miles from the customer in Pennsylvania, in Allentown. There is like a parking lot behind a cafe. It's very close to the customer. Already covered 350 kilometers by now, and another 100 kilometers, 450. So for tomorrow I will have 600, about 6 hours of driving. So I'm not in a rush. I will probably start rolling again 2-3 o'clock in the afternoon. The city of Hartland, Maine. And that means that The truck stop is about 20 minutes away. 20 more minutes to go to Kittery, Maine. Everything is good. We are having a nice trip. We are hauling a load of French fries. My reefer is set at minus 10 degrees Fahrenheit. Cycle mode is when your reefer start and stop. When it reaches a certain temperature, it stop and start again after a couple of times. And there is the other mode, is the continuous mode. Working continuously. £41,300 of French fries. Speed limit here is 50, so we have to reduce our speed. See you later from Irving truck stop in Kittery. I am almost at the truck stop here in the town of Kittery, where I'm gonna fuel up and hopefully I'm gonna find a place to park and stay for the night. Last week I was lucky, I took the only spot. It was only one spot available. And I took it last week. I am pretty sure it's gonna be very busy. It's gonna be packed, a lot of trucks. But first we have to fuel up.